Namaste and guten Tag. So let me share my screen. Speak a bit about Enerpark briefly, like about a minute or two, and then I'll take you through a few examples of solar photovoltaic solutions that we had implemented for commercial and industrial customers. I'd also speak a little bit about the process of guiding a customer or any commercial and industrial consumer through the process of selecting what kind of a renewable power mix or what kind of a solar power solution should they be adopting. Then I talk about a few challenges that currently developers as well as EPC players are facing in the market. And then I'd talk about a case in point of one particular project, just as Mr. Khare spoke about his own plant. So with that, I just brief you a bit about Enerpark. Enerpark, we are a global expert in solar power solutions. We have close to 3 gigawatts of projects that are done as a general contractor. And out of these, about 2 gigawatts are our own investments, projects that are done for the governments, as well as projects that are done for industrial and commercial customers. And these 2 gigawatts are spread over 455 plus solar projects across the world. Among these projects that we had built, we are operating about 2.2 gigawatts. So in terms of what I would like to highlight here is that we are a strong believer in the product that we actually sell, and we only and only do solar power solutions. So close to 2 gigawatts of our own investments is a testament for that. So we are headquartered in Hamburg, Germany. Other than Germany, the only other office where we have full service solutions provided are from Bangalore. Here we have a complete engineering team as well as a procurement team and a construction team. So we serve the 3 disciplines all from India. Also, we take care of a few markets in Southeast Asia as well as Middle East from India. So we're ranked number one in Europe, given the scale of investment as well as the number of projects that we had done, ranked number 7 in the world as an EPC company for solar power plants. The company as such is founded in 2008 by 3 individuals and the headquarters is in Germany, and it's completely privately held. There is no third party investment as such into the company. It is held by the 3 individuals. And as such, there is no, unlike many other renewable power developers or investors in India, we do investments in India, but we are entirely privately held. So this is our global footprint. As you can see, a considerable part of it is in Europe. In India, we are close to about 160 megawatts of projects that are done, and about close to 10 megawatts of investments that we had done on multiple commercial and industrial projects. And out of the 160 that we had actually built, we are operating close to 50 megawatts of these plants. The US operations has been recently divested to the toy maker company Lego to offset their carbon footprint due to the uses of plastic in producing the toys. And we are still helping them out in the transition. Enerpark in India is 100% subsidiary of Enerpark Germany. We are established in Jan 2015. That's about 5 years after we have been established in Germany. Headquartered in Bangalore, most of our team here has been in solar for a considerable long period of time. If you'd look at the solar journey, India had gone through a remarkable transition in the last 10 years. But our managing director, Mr. Santosh, has been in solar for close to 20 years, starting up by setting up the technology division for Tata BP Solar in India. And many of our team members here have been in the solar industry from the times of Tata BP Solar, close to about 20 years now. And that way we have seen solar go through many phases in India, from being a very, very, very early adopter to almost a mass adoption moment that we are seeing right now. It's still not there, but I think we are somewhere close to that. So we offer these three kinds of solutions. We do EPC, engineering, procurement, construction, for rooftop and ground-mounted projects in the C&I segment, as well as we do mid to large scale balance of system works for large developers for ground mount projects. And we do invest in rooftop and ground mount projects for commercial and industrial customers. And we also undertake operation and maintenance of already existing constructed projects by any other developer or EPC player, or including that of ours as well. Yeah. So I'd take a minute to talk about our presence across the country. As you can see, we are present from all the way in Haryana in the north till about Coimbatore in the south, as well as from Ahmedabad in the west to Assam in the east. So we perhaps spanned across the country with multiple projects. One of the recent projects is about a 35 megawatt solar power plant, which we had commissioned in Assam. Truly when we say we have a pan-India presence, we mean it, and we had done it as well. Now, a few marquee projects on the right side, you'd see we had done the first solar power plant about 150 meters away from an active runway. So this is one of our marquee projects. We had installed a 2 megawatts first, and then we had increased the capacity by another 5 megawatts in the Delhi International Airport. So close to 7 megawatts of solar power plants in the Delhi International Airport have been installed by us right next to an active runway. In fact, we have also relocated about 5 megawatts of these solar power plants from one location to another location, saving the modules and considerable part of the infrastructure that is already invested by the GMR international airports. So it is not just building a solar power plant, but perhaps even going ahead and relocating it from one location to another is a thing that we had done, and perhaps first of its kind again, in India. So one is building it right next to an active runway, and then again, relocating it when the runway was to be extended from one location to another, and all within the premises of an airport and within short timelines have been done by us. The next project actually is a project mounted on a ship-to-shore crane in Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust. These cranes actually vibrate quite a lot when they're in operations, and hence we had used here, copper, indium, gallium, selenide modules, or what we in general terms call as thin film modules, so that the vibration is not going to crack the glass up and the cells. So this is one of its kind of installation that is done off coast Mumbai in the JNPT port for APM Terminals, the Norwegian company. And we are, in fact, they're a key account for us, and we are doing one more project for them in Gujarat very soon, and that too in very challenging conditions on the coast. As I was explaining you, we've done the world's first solar relocation project on an active airport, moving a 5 megawatt solar power plant, over a 20 acre area from one location to another in an active airport. Also, the Hyderabad International Airport has 10 megawatts of solar power plants that are built by Enerpark and operated by us. A considerable part of the airport actually runs on Enerpark solar power plants. So this gives you an idea about commercial installations. In fact, the airports and ports are by themselves commercial examples, unlike the industrial examples that you had heard from Mr. Khare. While commercial is something that is not usually heard of, or is usually heard of in a very small context of retail stores and so on and so forth, but this is a different scale of commercial solar power adoption that we had done quite successfully in India. These are a few of our clients and who had been repeat customers. You would see many German companies as well, Kluber Lubrication, Nivea, the moisturizer company, and so on and so forth. So We are also building a 4 MW solar power plant for Reliance in Silvassa. Then Saint-Gobain, the French glass company, is a key account. We have done close to about 4 MW of solar power plants. And currently we are constructing about 3.5 MW of solar power plants on their roof as our own investments. Triton Valves, automotive company, is a customer. Kohler, the bathtub company. So as you can see, we had helped many of these customers, not just in understanding the benefits of solar, but helped them through the cycle of identifying which solution is good for them, whether they would, is it advantageous for them to actually invest by themselves, or is it good for us to actually go ahead and invest? That choice many a times is the last one that we address. We actually first address the need for solar. I mean, of course, the need is amply clear, but then we define the need and we make them understand what percentage of it can actually be catered through solar, both on-site, off-site. And then we go ahead and guide them through the process of selecting what kind of a solution would they want. They're open to doing a captive solar power plant, or they are even open to actually procure it from an open access kind of a model. And then we go ahead and actually help them take the decision on a CapEx or an OpEx. And I mean, this has happened with multiple clients, and usually it's a 6 month to 1 year process in any for any commercial or industrial customer to understand the need and then make a decision. And it may even go beyond a year. But all through this process, we guide the customer, we actually handhold them through this process. And most of these customers have actually given us repeat projects, and that indicates their the proof of the pudding. Then a few references. This is 1.25 megawatts project for Avery Dennison in Pune, Maharashtra, and 2 megawatts for Saint-Gobain Glass in Gujarat, to the right side. 980 kilowatts for Bharat Friswarna in Karnataka, Sauron Investment, and 7.9 megawatts Delhi International Airport that I spoke about, and the 10 megawatts Hyderabad International Airport, where the airport, to considerable extent is run on our solar power plants. These are a few references, but I'd kept the references brief, and I'd like to highlight a little bit about the aspects that are very key to actually making a decision to go solar, and the challenges. While Mr. Vinay has actually highlighted many of them in good amount of detail, I just touch upon them briefly. So many a times customers have this expectation, and the primary expectation being savings that come from the solar power. And of course, another main expectation is the sustainability goals and, carbon neutral goals, or, the customer by himself could be a part of have this RE100 goal that they would like to achieve by a certain timeline. So we understand the need first, we define it well. Then once we understand the why part of it, as to whether the savings is a primary motive or a RE100 goal is the primary motive, or an RPO obligation is the primary motive, the solutions can differ. The speed at which we execute the solutions can differ, and the scale at which we execute the solution can differ. So once we understand the first step, then we go ahead and analyze how to help them adopt to the renewable power, solar power, in their current business circumstance. So whether it needs to be done on site or off site. In fact, many customers who are on the commercial side, for example, commercial establishment, office spaces, malls, they may not have a rooftop space available to actually set up a solar power plant on their roofs, and they would like to go for an off site solution, where they may procure power through an open access route. And on-site, which is largely prevalent among industrial customers and a few commercial customers, has already been talked about. So that's one decision that we help them make. And to what extent, sometimes we hear customers saying, hey, we don't want to take power from the grid, and we just want to run completely on solar. And that's not going to happen so easily and no so fast. So there is time, there's at least another 5-10 years before we reach to that stage where storage becomes really affordable. So we also try to clear many of these misconceptions, or rather I would say well-intentioned thoughts, but then perhaps not achievable in the current scenario. So we try to actually work with them, make them understand what works, what doesn't work, whether a captive solar power plant will work for them or an open access. And really the last question, as I was telling, is whether it will be their own investment or they expend, or, I mean, whether it will be our own investment from Enerpark's end or investment from the client's end. So this is a question which we addressed the last once we defined the need and how to achieve it and whether in what mode it has to be achieved. So we had helped many customers adopt the solutions, maybe with another industry competitor, but we helped them go through the journey of identifying what suits them best. So in a sense, we evangelize solar. I mean, it doesn't really matter who does it, but at the end of it, helping people adopt to solar is a goal that we always work towards. And the fourth thing is the transparency on what can be and what cannot be. See, solar power is largely dependent on sunlight. You know, at the end of it, it isn't quite predictable as people would expect it to be, right? I mean, there are many things that come in between us and the sun. So I mean, it could be environment, it could be dust conditions, particularly in industrial environments, and rains that are not quite well predicted. The meteorological information in India is not to the point always. So while that said, we are also moving in the right direction where, you know, green energy is getting traded on exchanges. So as the industry adopts solar more and more, the predictability aspect of it will grow. But given what it is today and what it is perhaps across the world, the aspect of predictability is a bit of a question. And while we don't make tall claims, we make the customer understand this is possible and this isn't. The next aspect, which Vinay spoke in a bit of a detail about, is policy. And policy keeps changing quite a lot, particularly with respect to renewable power, because renewable power is always viewed as a competition. And particularly third-party renewable power is viewed as a competition by the distribution and the generation companies that are state-owned, which have been in losses due to many other reasons, due to lack of metering at an agricultural utilization, or due to lack of control in losses due to the transmission issue. So as Vinay was already telling, there's just 1% of the consumption is right now catered by rooftop solar. But the amount of flip-flops that the government has taken with, many state governments have taken with respect to the policy over the last couple of years, from restraining OPEC investments in Karnataka to, you know, many other things that have happened in other states. We had seen solar power and rooftop solar being considered as a threat by many state distribution companies. And that actually goes in loggerheads with the center's policy, where they're actually planning to put smart meters and giving the choice of, power to the customer. I mean, that's been talked about by the Honorable Finance Minister in the budget this year, that the government in the next couple of years will go towards a smart meter system where the choice of power will be given to the customer, who would be the end consumer. And we usually give a solution that is also futuristic. So say, for example, you want to integrate storage in the future with whatever is existing. We don't rule out that option. We also do the analysis for that, but we tell you this may not be adaptable today, but perhaps a couple of years down the line when storage becomes affordable. Challenges, as I had already touched upon, the approach of some state governments is not quite encouraging. Then the predictability of the meteorological data, environmental aspects, particularly in industrial environments where the pollution is a big aspect, as well as dust accumulation on occasions is a very big aspect. And the last, perhaps the most important in the current context, there is a wide gap between the demand for solar power in the country to the capabilities to actually cater to the market in India per se. So today, 80% of solar equipment actually are imported straightforward, and that sort of puts a question onto whether there will be a capability in India to cater to the demand. I mean, demand part of it is very clear. Over the last 3 months, what we are facing, even though there is COVID, many industrial customers are adopting to solar, but the original equipment manufacturer market has not been quite collaborative, of course, due to the ongoing border scenario, as well as many other policy-related issues that are there for imports, as well as lack of domestic capability and capacity to manufacture and cater to the industry. So this is another thing.
Please come to an end, yeah?
Yeah. So this is the last one, Tobias. So I'd conclude this. This is a project which we had invested upon. Though we have done investments which are bigger than this, I would like to briefly talk about it, because this is a project which adopts solar on warehouses, RCC buildings, the ground area, and the parking locations. So we had provided a technical and financial solution that adopts solar in various forms in a very small place. So that's pretty much what I had, and thanks a lot.